Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today, I am going to talk about prefix expression evaluation. For today's session, the contents are how the stack can be used for the expression evaluation. For expression evaluation, what are the steps we need to apply? That I am going to explain with the help of examples. Objective of the today's session are, at the end of this session, every learner will be able to understand the evaluation of prefix expression and for evaluation how the stack can be used. Before starting the expression evaluation, I would like to explain what are different applications that can be implemented with the help of stack. So, stack can be used for implementation of reversing the data, parenthesis parsing, function calls. These are the applications which are already explained in the previous video lecture named stack data structure. The next application is expression conversion. Here we can convert the expression from one form to another form. This application also separately explained in the separate videos named expression conversion of infix to prefix form and infix to postfix form. And now I am going to focus on expression evaluation, one of the application of stack. Here I am going to focus on prefix expression evaluation. So now let's start with the steps for prefix expression evaluation. So very first step is reverse the prefix expression. Next, we need to scan character from the prefix expression. This step will be just same as of the postfix expression evaluation. Next, we need to take decision about whether the scan character is operand or operator. If it is operand, push it onto the stack, just same as of the postfix expression evaluation. But if the scan character is operator, we need to perform these sub steps. So if the operator is scan, perform two consecutive pop operations. Why two pop operations we need to perform? So the answer is, whatever the operator is scan from the prefix expression, that operator is binary operator, and to evaluate with the help of binary operators, two operands will require, and that both the operands will get from the stack itself. That's why we'll perform two pop operations onto the stack to get two operands to perform respective operation with the help of this operator, which is scan from the prefix expression. The next step is, here we need to form the order of the operands. Treat first pop operand as a first operand and second pop operand as a second operand in arithmetic operation. This will be just opposite to the postfix expression evaluation. Next step will be, perform respective arithmetic operation for the operator which is scan from the postfix expression. Push generated result back onto the stack after the arithmetic operation and repeat all above steps till end of the prefix expression. We need to repeat the steps from true 2 to 5 because reversing of the prefix expression is required one time operation, and all rest of the operations we need to perform repeatedly till end of the prefix expression. At the end, the single value will be available there onto the stack. That will be the result of expression evaluation. Now let's look what are the steps which are different from the postfix expression evaluation. So these only the two steps which are different, that of the postfix expression evaluation. Now I am going to explain one example, or the first example, where I am going to evaluate the prefix expression. Here again, just as of the previous video, I am going to divide this slide into three sections: reversed prefix expression, the stack, and the evaluation. The expression must be in reversed form. So let's start with the reversed expression. Here initially the stack is empty. I am going to scan the first character from prefix expression is nothing but the operand. That's why push it onto the stack. The 5 is operand, again push it onto the stack. Next scan character is operator. That's why perform two pop operations. Now here we are performing prefix expression evaluation. That's why the first pop operand is going to become a first operand into the expression evaluation, and second pop operand is going to become a second into the expression evaluation. The scan operator was the minus operator. That's why we are going to perform subtraction operation on the expression, and the result is 1. Push it back onto the stack, and here 1 is onto the stack again. The next scan characters are the operands. That's why push it onto the stack. The next is operator. That's why perform 2 pop operations. Now the first pop operand is 2, is going to become a first operand. Second pop operand is 3, is going to become a second operand. The scan operator was the plus operator. That's why addition is we are going to perform, and the result we are going to push back onto the stack. The next scan operator is the multiplication operator. Perform multiplication on the data which is pop from the stack and perform the operation. At the end, we need to push back result onto the stack. That will be the final result of the prefix expression evaluation. Let's look the second example where I am going to explain. This is the infix expression, and its equivalent prefix expression is like this. Let's perform the operation onto the prefix expression. We are going to scan the character from the prefix expression in reverse order. That is, reverse order will be 2, 3, power operator, 6, 3, 6, divide, multiplication and subtraction. In this order, we are going to perform the operation. So now let's see the first scan character is operand. We are going to perform push operation. That's why push it onto the stack. The next one is 3. Push it onto the stack. Next one is operator. That's why perform 2 pop operation, evaluate and push back result onto the stack. Now here again the first pop operand will become a first operand itself, and the second one is going to become a second. That's why here we'll perform 3:2 operation. Result will be 9, and result will push back onto the stack. Next, 6 push onto the stack, 3 push onto the stack, again 6 push onto the stack. Next scan character is operator. Perform the operation by performing 2 consecutive pop operations. That's why we will perform the pop operation. 6 is pop from a stack. Here it must be 3. 6 is pop from a stack, and then 3 is pop from a stack is going to become a second operand. This must be 3. I am repeating. By mistake, I have written it as 2, but this must be 3, and 6 divided by 3 result will be 2, and that push back onto the stack. Next scan operator is multiplication operator. Again, perform 2 conjugative pop operations. 6 into 2 result will be 12. That is pushed back onto the stack. And the last scan operator is nothing but the subtraction operator. Perform subtraction and the result is pushed back onto the stack. At the end, a single value is available into the stack. It means we have done with the prefix expression evaluation and stack is holding the result of evaluation. And here we have done with the expression evaluation. Thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the contents and the video, please like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.